Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and this video is all about Google Chrome optimization. If you use Google Chrome as your main browser like I do, there may be some default Google Chrome settings you want to adjust. So here are five Google Chrome settings to change now. Now, you guys know how I love a quick tip before we dive into a list. Heck, I love quick tips in general. So, quick tip. Before you do anything, and while you use your Chrome browser, always be sure to keep your Chrome browser up to date. It's really easy to do so, and sometimes it does it automatically for you. And if you need any help on that, just let me know in the comments below. Now you can see here at the day I'm shooting this video, I'm running this latest official build version. Now, on to the five Google Chrome settings you need to change now. Number one on the list, clear your browser data. Think of this like a nice little initial clean for your Google Chrome browser. So to access this and any of these Chrome settings, as a matter of fact, from any tab in your Chrome browser, click on the three-dot menu icon in the top right here, and then just select Settings. To clear your browsing data, scroll down to the Privacy and Security section here and select Clear Browsing Data. Now, in this pop-up, you can select a time range at the top. Then you can select what you want to clear. So you can clear your entire browsing history, you can clear cookies and other site data, and then you can clear cached images and files. So quick note, when you clear your cookies, you'll be signed out of any sites that you're currently signed into. So if you're used to just opening a site and being automatically signed in, you'll have to manually sign in after clearing those cookies. So once you've selected everything you want to clear, just click Clear Data. So now that you've cleared your browser data, we can move on to number two on the list, and that's auto delete your browser data. Basically, you can choose how long you want to keep your web and app activity for. So again, from your settings, click on Manage your Google account. Now this is going to open a new tab, and from here, just select Manage your data and personalization. You can also click it from the left-hand side here too. Now, here under Web and App Activity, click the arrow to open some more controls. Here you can choose an auto delete option. Just select how often you want to delete your activity, and any data older than that will be automatically deleted from your account. Your entire Google account here on an ongoing basis. Tip number three on the list, turn off notifications. This may seem like a really simple tip to make a list like this, but if you're easily distracted, you may want to can it with the notifications. So here's how to do that. Again, from your settings, click on Privacy and Security, and then select Site Settings. Now, from here, first of all, you can adjust some camera and microphone permissions here too, but if you head down to Notifications, yours may say ask before sending, for example, which is a default setting in Chrome, but click on this and now here you can site by site grant or deny notification permissions. But first, I want you to look at the top here. You can toggle on the option to use quieter messaging. So Chrome will intuitively block notifications from interrupting you. But to go site by site, as an example here, sometimes, you know, I get a ton of Facebook notifications and they can be annoying constantly popping up on my screen. So I can click on Facebook here, and then here under notifications, I can just select block. Coming in at number four on the list, block third-party cookies. Now this can essentially stop some sites from tracking you. Back in those settings, head back to your Privacy and Security and click on Cookies and Other Site Data. So maybe I should explain further. Basically, advertisers can use cookies to track your browsing data. So, you know, like when you're searching for something on the web and then all of a sudden you keep seeing ads for those sneakers or something that you're searching? Those are cookies. So from here, you can block all third-party cookies if you feel so inclined to do so. Or you know what? You can even just clear cookies and site data every time you quit Chrome. Here's the thing. If you're really concerned about privacy and who's tracking you, you may want to reconsider which browsers you use in the first place. And also maybe never walk around with a small computer in your pocket every single day. But this is just a nice way to have a little bit more control. And now I have saved the best for last. Coming in at number 5 on the list is to manage and add different search engines, essentially allowing you to search multiple sites really quickly. This is a big one. So we're back in our trusted settings page, and this time click on search engine on the left. Now, here at the top, we can toggle to select different search engines to be used in the address bar. I don't know why you'd ever want to not Google it, but maybe you're a Bing girl or a DuckDuckGo boy, and if that's the case, you go for it. So you can adjust that right here. But further adjustments are available in this Manage Search Engines section. So go ahead and click that. And here you have a list of default search engines at the top, and then other search engines underneath those. Now this is where things get really cool, so pay attention. We're using keywords so you can search in any search engine from your default search engine Chrome browser bar. Are you following? Because you should be. So here's how to do it. Click on Add just underneath these default browsers. And let's say we want to quickly search Wikipedia for something. So in the search engine field, we're going to type in Wikipedia. And then in this keyword field, this is where you want to enter a text shortcut that you want to use for the search engine. And make it a shortcut that you're actually going to remember and use. So, you know, for this example, I'm just going to type in Wiki. Now, on the last field is where you're going to add the URL, but it's not a standard URL web address, so it's not just going to be like wikipedia.org for this example. So what you're going to do is go to the search engine that you want to add, and now here you're going to actually do a search. Search for whatever, it really doesn't matter. Of course, I'm going to search for Habs. Now, whatever you've searched for, copy that address for this search results page. So right up here at the top in your browser bar, copy that. Now back in your Chrome settings, where you left off, paste that address into this URL section. Now I want you to replace the search term at the end here with a percentage symbol and a lowercase s. You're just replacing the search term at the end. Now, after you've added that, here's where the magic happens. Open up a new Chrome tab, and in the browser bar, just type in your shortcut that you just created. So I'll type in Wiki, and look at this. Chrome will prompt you to hit Tab in order to search in that search engine directly. So after you hit Tab, just enter your search term. And voila, you're given results only from that search engine. How neat is this? And just so you guys know, you can of course edit. Let's go back to the settings. You can edit any of these existing ones here back in your search engine settings on Chrome. So like you'll see how my keywords here are all the full site, for example. I can just click on this menu icon to the right. I'm gonna select edit. And then I'm going to change the keyword to something shorter. Okay, and now just like we saw for the Wikipedia example, if I only want to search DuckDuckGo from my browser bar, I can do that with this shortcut I just created, which is duck. Woo! Amazing. How cool is that? It's a game changer, time saver just for you. So those are my top 5 Google Chrome settings to change now. And now I want to hear from you. What are some Chrome settings that you've changed and why? Let everybody know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you like this video, I want to know. So give it a like, give it a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Google content. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time.